and ensure that people who may have been innocently caught up on the wrong side of things and those not implicated in crimes be released and charges against them withdrawn. This will enable the agencies to focus their resources, efforts, and time in investigating and prosecuting serious criminal elements who took advantage of peaceful demonstrations to advance a dangerous agenda of lawlessness, anarchy, and mayhem. It is important that these suspects are brought to book and that they are prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. I also take this opportunity to affirm the constitutional authority and duty vested on our national security institutions to protect our country against internal and external threats to sovereignty, to lives of our people, our rights, freedoms, property, peace, stability, and prosperity, as well as our collective national interest. Consequently, I call on the National Police Service to use its mandate responsibly, professionally, and effectively in full compliance with the Constitution, with a view to promoting the national objectives of Article 238, 239, and 244 of our Constitution. All breaches and violations by police officers must be handled expeditiously through due process with a view to giving Kenyans a police service that upholds the highest standards of integrity. As citizens of this great nation, we all have a duty to balance our rights and responsibilities at all times so that the legitimate exercise of our rights and freedoms does not undermine our broader aspirations to remain a civilized, democratic, and peaceful country governed under the rule of law and institutions of governance for the benefit of all of us.